I've built a total of 3 bandsaws so far, one of which is right behind me, and my first one, an 18-inch bandsaw, is here. And I want to build a bigger one, a 20-inch bandsaw, and I'll start by making the wheels. The design of these wheels is going to be very similar to those on my 16-inch bandsaw. It's best to start with good materials, but I like to use old crap, like this shipping crate plywood. I could have finished the cuts on the jigsaw, but the bandsaw is a lot quicker. The plywood wasn't big enough for 4 contiguous circles, so I'm piecing it together and reinforcing it out of dowels. I just went shopping and I bought the shaft and the bearings, and these bearings are 52 millimeters outside diameter, which means to get a hole of the right size I need to set this to 26 millimeters. My first test hole is too small. I need a tight fit, but I think this is too small by 2 millimeters almost, so I have to make a bigger test hole. I way overcompensated, way too loose. Okay, this is actually the 4th attempt. This is actually a pretty good fit because I want that to be in there super tight. This was actually just a test fit. The actual flanges are going to be out of much higher quality Baltic birch plywood. The only way to get the bearing back out is to destroy the test flange. The bearings need to fit in the flanges super tight. If you can get them at all in there with a reasonable amount of force, they'll work themselves loose. In earlier bandsaw builds, I always clamped the flanges on by putting bar clamps through holes in the wheels, but I found those always moved the flange a little bit, so by making these clamps I can avoid that. I didn't get all the wobble out. My glue set up a little bit too fast for me. So for the lower wheel, I did all the alignment now without having added any glue to it, but I added these two small screws, and I just have to make sure I put this on the same way again with the glue, and hopefully my alignment will be good because of the screws. I've got the screw sticking out just a little bit, and I have A marked on here and here. So just try and hit the old screw holes. And the alignment is still good. So now I can clamp that and check it some more. That's acceptable considering how non-flat my plywood is. This is now my third bandsaw build that I'm using this temporary pulley, which I made out of a piece of plywood by cutting some slots in it on the table saw. If you're afraid of doing that, you can just use three layers of plywood. I have a small utility motor, 1750 RPM with a 2-inch pulley, and I'll use that to spin up the wheel. And this clamp on here makes sure the pulley doesn't slide away on me. Now the actual circumference I'm aiming for is 156.4 centimeters, and right now I've got 161 centimeters. So I've got quite a bit that I still need to turn off of here. I've now got the wheel turned flat and to the right radius. Now I just have to turn a crown onto it. Got the crown turned onto it and sand it, and this wheel is done. I'm adding an extra layer to the drive wheel, which will allow me to offset the pulley later. The screws were in there just for clamping. This ring, which is made out of two layers of plywood, is going to form the pulley for the lower wheel. So the wheel has clearly got a heavy spot down here, so I should drill that out, but how much? So to gauge that, I'm putting some blocks on top of here to see if that's enough to balance it. And those seem to just about balance it. I should drill out about as much wood as corresponds to the weight of these. So I've had to drill out quite a bit here to balance it, but that is a function of using very cheap plywood. The top wheel wasn't as bad. I only had to drill one hole here. The inside of the bicycle inner tube is covered with a powder to keep it from sticking to itself, but we want that tube to stick to the wheel as much as possible. I still need to take that tube off again and varnish the whole wheel, but as you can see, this new bandsaw is going to be quite a bit bigger than this one.